throw a large bowl using the rib. There is a video. I have thrown a small one, but it was just a beginner-sized piece of clay. And it really doesn't show the potential of the rib. So once you get a hold of the rib, you can really throw some big pieces. Okay, a bowl is just a big cylinder that's opened up. So I'm going to throw a large cylinder and then with the rib open it up into a bowl. What I'm opening, I like to open with the top at about a 45 degree angle. You can take out those plugs of clay. It's easier to take them out than try to move all this stuff in the middle over. And I always start off with lots of clay so I don't miss this amount of clay. And after you've done that, you've really got it open, and now you can start opening the bottom. I do the bottom the same way the large piece as I do the small. Just bring it across with my right, palm of my left. You let it open, you can move to the inside and pull across. I'm still pulling across with my left hand. My left hand is considerably lower than my right at this point, and I'm still making the bottom. I'm getting it taller and thinner, making sure you keep a cylinder or a toe in shape. You don't want it to go out and be a bowl until you tell it to be a bowl. Pots like to make bowls, so we'll just keep it a cylinder. Also, don't let your rim get too thin, because this is the part that's going to be open the most. And if it's at a thin stage now, by the time you've opened, this is going to be twice as big. This is going to be half as wide. And so if you start off with a normal size rim, it's going to be too thin. And a big bowl like this has to have a strong finish on the top. It has to come up and say, I'm done now. Instead of just sometimes rims get thin. And they look more like they ran into clay than actually finish the pot. So now I'm going to open this into a bowl. Like I said, this will make a fairly large bowl. Oh, well, frankly, I'm going to clean out the bottom. I didn't go in there. I've got lots of water, and it's uneven. At this point, you want to go across and work your bottom. It does a couple of things. One, it makes it nice and smooth until it contacts all of those particles in there, so you never get the S-crack in the middle that you get with larger plates and bowls. I'm working on the radius of this, and then going a little bit past, back and forth. And I like a nice, a bowl I think should have a smooth interior. So mine do, because I like it. And I'm going to have one more pull across the bottom. And now I'm going to use the rib to open this. Like I said, it'll be a fairly large bowl. I go down with it at a 45 degree angle. I like this rib because I can get a hold of it. I'm balancing on the top with my left hand, my elbows on my knees, my elbows are tucked into my rib. My ribs, and I'm going to go down about a 45 degree angle. As I get down to the bottom, you can see the part that I'm using. If I get down to the bottom, the pressure will come to the end of the rib, and I'll bring that rib into my tummy, and it'll make a nice join from the side, from the wall to the bottom. And also, if you bring it towards your tummy, it'll stop it from chattering. If it starts to chatter in that roller coaster ride, it really is a bother. Seems hard to get off. So I'm going to do that another time. And I pull it into my tummy, making a nice join from the wall to the bottom. Now I'm going to give it a pull because as I open up the walls, the particles tend to splay open. And I'm just going to give it more of not a shaping pull, but a compacting pull, and I'm going to compact the top. And now I want to compact that ridge, the rim. If you do that, chances are in drying, you will get V cracks along the edges where you forced it open. So I'm going to do it again. At this point, you can open it up as much as you like or as you dare. Keeping in mind that this clay here is holding the weight of that. So again, I'll just compact those particles as they open. And just for the sake of it, I'll do it one more time, just because I want to. I'll open a little bit more there, and just change the profile. And so with the rib, as long as you do most of your throwing, you can see where it's dirty. With that part, and moving the whole rib up and down, not trying to make the rib move that way, but this part goes up and down the sides, and holding on to both the handle and the top. You have control over this thing, and it will do what you ask. Another technique is a lot of times when you're throwing a bowl, the top part, this part to here, tends to want to flop, and you get a weird profile. So the last pull of the bowl, what I want to do is I'm just going to run my sponge, it's below my right hand, and I'm kind of pushing up this way, and it keeps that profile in check. I'm not pushing hard, just enough to bend the clay. And you see there, it's a little more controlled. As you see with the rib, if you start with a big enough cylinder, you can make a very large bowl. I could do another one if I want to. I kind of like this one the way it is. So there's showing a large piece with the perfect profile rib. And there's me just tidying up that profile one more time. And compact. You see, when I started off with that thick edge, I've got a nice rim. That bowl comes up and says, I'm done, and doesn't have that wishy-washy skinny rim. That's it. You can go away now.